Hello, friends. Thanks so much for joining me on another APCW Zoom interview. Today, I'm fortunate enough to have caught up with Naomi Barton from Clarion, or excuse me, it's from IGB Live and IGB Amsterdam. Is that correct, Naomi?
It is IGB Affiliate Amsterdam.
And IGB Affiliate Amsterdam. So sorry. But you are with, I mean, Clarion's associated, and that's why that I wanted you guys to come on today, because there's been some scare in the news over in Europe about the COVID bug coming back. However, IGB Live and IGB Affiliate Amsterdam are still moving forward. And I'm sure some affiliates out there are curious to hear from you guys about since the event's going on, about how you're dealing with the current situation and exactly what you're doing to alleviate the threat and people's fears associated with COVID.
Yes, I mean, I guess the first thing to say is in terms of how the situation is over in Europe and the UK, fortunately, after sort of 18 months of obviously living in the way that we have, things are really very much moving in the right direction. So we are seeing a mass reduction in cases. The vaccination program is going really well. The UK, 80% of our adult population is vaccinated, and the Netherlands is following closely behind. So the EU is in a good position and we're seeing all the right things. So the Dutch government has basically sanctioned the use of a coronavirus pass system, which means that people can attend the event as long as they can show proof of a negative test or they have that double vaccination status. And we're obviously working very closely with the RAI, with the City of Amsterdam, with the Netherlands government, with our governments and also governments around the world to ensure that we can get people there safely and securely and make sure that we have all of those safety measures in place, because I think we wouldn't run something unless we felt that we could do it safely and securely, but also that our customers want it and that we can drive the value and the ROI for our customers, because we want to reconnect the community, but only if we can do it in a safe and secure way that makes people feel good about attending.
Right. You mentioned the safety procedures and precautions you're taking. Is there anything specific that you guys are doing at the event in this regard?
Yeah, I mean, there'll be ways in which we can do things to make people feel better as a general rule. So that's additional cleaning measures. That's making sure that we still apply and adhere to certain social distancing measures that you'll have to show. As we said, you'll have to show a proof of vaccination status when you get to the event as well. We'll have testing facilities on site. Anybody that has a positive test won't be allowed into the venue. You know, so we've got some quite stringent measures in place to allow you to enter. And then when you actually get inside, obviously there will be that additional cleaning and that additional space. We've got more space for all of our feature areas. So everything is a lot more spaced out and we don't have to congregate people in the same place. We've obviously got certain amounts of people that can come in at any one time. So we're restricting that flow of people at any one time so we don't become crowded at any point. So we're really confident that we're working as much as we can to deliver an experience that doesn't take away from what someone might expect from a normal event or a normal IGB Live. So all the good stuff, but at the same time, it just makes people feel more secure that we've done everything we can to make sure their participation, their visit is, you know, feels good to them.
Sure. That makes sense. And that's, you know, everyone seems to be following basically the same script. So, you know, the thing is, there hasn't been a live event in I think about 18 months now. However, you guys bringing this back, I mean, a lot of it has to do with the loyalty of your customers. They want the event. They want to come there.
Yeah, I mean, I think we do a lot of sentiment surveys. Obviously, we're nothing without our customers in the respect that we wouldn't be able to do anything if our customers didn't want us to do it. So we've got a very loyal customer base that when this sort of all started 18 months ago, we have tried to stay as close as we possibly can to our community as possible, to the affiliate community, to the iGaming community. We've spoken to them every turn. We've tried to understand how they feel about things. And certainly, you know, we haven't been able to run something of this size and scale in the last year and a half. And that's been a shame, but it's been the right thing to do. So we've talked, you know, we've connected with them in other ways. We've pivoted online at times. We've run things that mean we can connect virtually. However, we know that this audience is it's incredibly loyal, and it's a community that really wants to meet face to face. So we know that what they want, you know, the last sentiment survey that we ran, which we do on a regular basis, probably about once a month, is that 70% plus want to be back together, want to see each other in a live in-person format. So if our customers are asking us to do that, and we know we can provide that connection in a live environment in a safe and secure way, then we'll do it. Should that change, then we will look at it. But we are lucky that I think this is a good community, and they do share what they feel, and what they feel is that they want to come back together, and they trust us to be able to do that. And so that's a good position to be in. But we've had a lot of conversations. We spend a lot of time talking to our customers, and you know, they're very open with how they feel. And at the moment, they're very excited about coming back together.
You know, it's funny because I, as an American, it's so complicated with the states and going across the ocean. And I don't just have to deal with like what's coming out of the UK, getting into the UK, then getting out, but also every state over here has different rules and travel restrictions. So it's quite difficult. But even though I can't attend this event, I'm looking forward to London and find myself actually getting excited that we're even having an event at all. But when we were speaking before we went on and started recording this, you had mentioned that even ahead of the event, you guys have like things in place to help people network and connect. I think there was a match program. So can you explain a little bit about that?
Yeah, so one of the primary reasons that people come to our events is to network and connect. So when we look at all the things we offer, networking and connection, sort of business meetings, is always number one as to reason as to why people attend. So we're obviously focusing this year on making sure that we match the right people together. So when we have our audience of our visitors and matching those with the right suppliers and the right affiliate programs and the right operators. So we have an app that we're going to be using, obviously, that fundamentally people will be able to utilize and download ahead of the event, and they can connect and they can arrange business meetings with people that they want to do business with. They can understand who's going to be at the event, and they can connect in with them to arrange those one-to-one business meetings. And then we'll facilitate that live on site, and they can have their meetings either on their stands or they can have their meetings in our VIP lounge, but they'll be able to schedule and create those connections before they actually get on site. And really fundamentally, that just means that people can make sure their time is maximized, that their time is not wasted, and they can meet the right people, because these are people that are looking to reconnect after probably, you know, a long time of not seeing people face to face, but they're also interested in meeting new suppliers and seeing new products and making new connections. So this is a way of them being able to schedule their time, you know, across those 2 days when actually that's when they're going to be there.
Right. And mentioning your VIP lounge, you said something about a slot lounge as well. And I believe you guys are doing something with the esports as well at this upcoming event.
Yeah, so one of the things we're keen to do is continually bring new products, new innovation, and also to reconnect and connect up the ecosystem. So we know that slots is something that's super relevant at the moment, and we want to provide those new games so that people can obviously understand with new generations of younger players who play, and you've got the affiliate and you've got the operators and you've got the gaming providers, and we want to connect that ecosystem up all in one place and demonstrate those new games and be able to showcase those new products and innovations, which is great. And then we've also, you know, another vertical is the esports sort of sector. And again, esports connects in with affiliation. Everyone's trying to understand really how the esports sort of core betting sector works. And so we're going to have an esports streamer cube where we'll have live streamers playing games throughout and playing tournaments throughout. And again, just showcasing a bit of fun, a bit of innovation, but also a lot of learning to really educate our ecosystem sort of, you know, about that new sector and about that new vertical and how that can benefit really ultimately drive their business and grow their business.
Well, now you made me extremely sad that I'm not going to be able to be there, but I do thank you so much for coming on and being so open and transparent and forthcoming with information to help alleviate any concerns that were out there and to help pique interest about your upcoming events. So if somebody wants more information, they want to register, maybe they've been on the fence, are they going to the igblive.com website?
Yeah, that's correct. So it's igblive.com is where they can go to register. They are very welcome to get in touch with me directly. I'm naomi.barton@clarionevents.com. I will talk to anybody and I will give any information I need. So we welcome all sort of queries and questions. And so also for those...
you have your home phone number you want to give out?
Just the email, I think, is fine. The email will work for everybody.
All right.
But I guess the other thing is that, you know, we will also be streaming and we'll be creating content that then we will share post-show, and we will be able to push out with videoing live on site, and then we'll be taking that and putting it across all of our channels. So anyone who can't attend will be able to connect up with the content and with the products that they see sort of post-event.
That's awesome. That's awesome. I'll definitely be taking advantage of that. Naomi, thank you so much. I know that it's dinner time over there. It's breakfast time here. So I'm going to go have a good English muffin.
Amazing. Enjoy.
Thank you very much. We'll see you soon.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Take care. Bye.